like my, did you forget we know you're not with any inch of the real, real, so stop it. I ain't knocking your little hustle, but watch it. I would hate to hear that loud, ooh, jitty, jitty, bang, jitty, jitty, bang. Oh, them cannons rain, yeah, some
cannons. EA Sports coverage of the NFL playoffs brings us to a sold out and absolutely rocking Caesars Superdome in downtown New Orleans. Straight ahead, it's Wild Card Weekend, and we've got a great one in store between the Arizona Cardinals and the New Orleans Saints. Winner go home is the mantra, and off we go. NFC wild card game. And he opts to not bring this one out. The first drive will start at the 25. Zero, and this is not the way to start a drive. He didn't even try to signal for a timeout, so they must have not been aware of the numbers.
I think he lost track of the time left in the play clock and probably was trying to read the defense and trying to figure out which play to run and just lost track, and it cost him.
So a little bit of a stiffer challenge now. First and 15 following the delay of game. To throw is Murray. He finds Hopkins complete. They get 14 yards, but not enough for the first down due to the previous penalty.
One thing we do know, he's going to get his catches. So as they move forward defensively, got to continue to focus on not giving up the big play when he does catch the ball in the secondary.
Just a yard to go here on second down. Nyheim Hines, his first carry. And he's going to have just a couple here with a marker on the field as well. That time, the right guard sending him backwards.
And so many different types of guys rotate in on the defensive line now, depending on situations. You can get the bulky guy, the fast guy. No matter what, though, you can't hold them.
They'll come up now on a second and long after the hold. Now a give, right side. Hines, and he'll take it forward for about five up to the 28-yard line.
A quick burst there, and he nicely bit off a pretty decent game.
A tough spot here on their opening drive. This is third and seven. They fake the handoff. Now Murray. He'll air this one out for Kirk. He's got a man complete. And he's going to get this down to the 35-yard line. A big connection on that one. 37 yards.
Brandon, we've both been around the game long enough that we know that in pregame, defenses are pretty amped up, aren't they? I mean, they're pounding lockers, and they can't wait to get out there. But when you hit them with some big pass plays early, it takes the starch right out of them.
So that changes things a bit. Here's a first and 10 all the way down at the 35. From the gun, Murray. And this will be incomplete.
Well, Charles, you talk about this offense, and you think about the man in charge, their head coach, this marking his first ever playoff game as the head coach, and you wonder what's going through his mind right about now.
Brandon, I think we both agree that he's had a great season, and we wouldn't be surprised at all to see him get plenty of Coach of the Year votes. I thought he took the right tone in his weekly press conference, though. Played it cool, took the reserved angle. And when you don't have the track record, I think that's the exact right way to do it.
9 yards, and that leaves him just short, so it'll be third and less than a yard. Play fake, Murray. He'll check this down to Hines. So he'll be stopped here for no gain. And that's going to make it fourth down. And they're getting him involved early.
You feel like they saw something on tape, or they just have a sense with him because he's had a good week of practice or something in that area, that they want him involved, just as you said. They want him to touch it either in the running game or the passing game, but they must like the matchups they're getting.
They'll run for it with Hines. And he's going to get the first down here as he's taken down at the 22.
Thought they might throw the football with a little chunk that they had remaining on fourth down, but they ran it. They got it.
And the reason they were able to get it done, he ran that play with conviction, didn't he? Understood he would get a little bit of help from his friends up front, but it was really on him to go ahead and make the power move and get.
And that is caught. Touchdown, Cardinals. Colby Parkinson. There to make the grab. And the Cardinals will strike first here in this wild card matchup. Lutz good on the extra point. And that makes the score 7-0.
Cardinals 7, Saints nothing. Will Lutz set to kick off.
After the touchdown, Lutz to kick it off. A fair catch signaled for and taken successfully.
The Saints take over first and 10 at their own 25-yard line.
They'll run it for the first time with Alvin Kamara. And nothing doing. He's immediately taken down at the line of scrimmage. The UCLA product, Kenny Young, had the tackle.
Defensively, we always know that he is tough in run support. And I think the way that he gets there is he understands what an offense is going to do before the ball's even snapped. A great job of scouting prior to the game, then reading, reacting, and taking the right path to the ball carrier.
He'll buy some time right. It's a short one here, complete to his tight end. Only 3 yards on the catch. It's third down.
We'll see what kind of mindset they have here offensively after giving up the touchdown on the opening drive.
And based on our time with them, you know, prior to this game, I feel like they've got a good mindset going in. In fact, the discussion that we had with the coaching staff was, you know, we may give up some points in this game, so our offense has to be ready each and every time to either equal or try and get us ahead and try and keep us ahead. This is their chance to respond to that first touchdown given up.
On third down, he'll drop to throw.
And that's caught. It's Brian Edwards.
And he is going to have a Saints first down as they're able to get the third down conversion.
And already down 7-0 after the touchdown a minute ago. So a 3-and-out here would not be ideal for them. Nice job finding his receiver there. And they get the first down.
Now a first down carry. It's Kamara. And they'll get him down after a pickup of 8. 2nd and 2.
Good running right there. And this is a man who was a 1,000-yard rusher in the regular season, so you know he's going to get his chances. And he picks up nice yardage on that one.
Only needing 2 yards on 2nd down. They'll look to throw.
throwing the out route and complete. It's Edwards. And he'll take this to the other side of midfield before going out of bounds.
A little football 101 there. You just see the receiver try to run down the defender, meaning he goes right at him and really trying to move him a little bit towards the center of the field so he can put his foot in the ground and break to the out to the sideline and make a catch.
And he'll work this forward for about three. It's second down.
Score, Cardinals 7, Saints nothing.
They're going to look to throw. And a quick throw here, that's complete. And he got blown up. Losing yardage on the play back at the 44. Now they're staring at a 3rd and 8. That last play, backwards a yard. Back to throw here. He's got his all-pro receiver, Michael Thomas. And he is going to have a Saints first down as they're able to get the 3rd down conversion. So 1st and 10 now from the 30.
Saints first down. 1st and 10 at the 30-yard line.
Back to the ground. It's Kamara. And he's got about 5 yards as he's taken down right at the 25. Solid running there. And, CD, we hear so much about what it takes to win in the playoffs. Most people like to include having a strong running game in their assessment. And with this man in the backfield, this group has a strong running game without a doubt.
Oh, I absolutely agree with you there, because in terms of yardage, he's a top 5 running back in the league. And in terms of impact on a game, not many better than him. And when they're flowing and he's carrying the ball consistently, they're tough to beat.
And that'll fall incomplete. He was hit just as he let that go. And now it's 3rd down. Already a pair of 3rd down conversions for them on this drive, but right now they need 5 yards on this 3rd down try. On play action, they'll throw. Into heavy traffic, and it's intercepted. Picked up by Marco Wilson. And the Cardinals are going to get it back here just past the 35. But no doubt, a very disappointing end to what was a pretty strong opening drive.
They had 3 points in their back pocket. It was there for them. If you don't like what you see, just throw it away. Make sure you get those points on the board. Don't get too greedy. He forced it there. You saw the end result.
Ready to go with their next drive, and at the line, the Cardinal offense. Here's a handoff to Hines to begin the drive. Finding some room at midfield. And he is into the end zone. Touchdown, Arizona. The CD, I mean, there are touchdown runs, and then there are touchdown runs, and that one certainly fell into the latter category. Now that deserves a couple exclamation points.
And this is a play defensively where you're just looking around and saying, what was that? What just happened? You're looking at your teammates, they're looking at you. And let's face it, your defensive coordinator, he's not going to tip his cap to it. And that's not how football works, but he probably should have after that run. That was absolutely sensational.
And this will not be returned. It's a touchback, and they'll begin at the 25. Getting set for their next drive, the New Orleans offense. And there are parts of their last drive they'd like to emulate. And, of course, they'd like to forget the ending, the interception. But they did put together, Charles, a nice sustained drive to get him down the field.
Yeah, and unfortunately for them, the only thing that matters is part two, right? Because once they threw the interception and finished off the drive, that does them no good to go back and say, well, you know, we had a good one going. Finish things off. That's the only way you can get it done.
So So the incompletion, and now it's second and 10, again from the 25-yard line. Off the play fake, he'll look to throw. Looking left side, and it's complete. And he'll go out near midfield at the 49.
When you're struggling on offense, you're looking for anything possible to get you going. Sometimes you do it like basketball teams that don't normally press. You put a press on, bring people to life, make them move a little bit quicker. Maybe that'll help them as they head towards the half.
Single, 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 single. No, no, no. Off.
Check, check, check. Now a play fake here on first down. On the check down, he finds Kamara. And just 1 yard here from the 49 to the 50.
As a defense, you're more balanced when you're in zone coverage because you're able to keep your eyes on the quarterback and see the play develop in front of you. They're able to keep the quick pass in front of them and stop it right at the line of scrimmage.
The play action fake. They'll look to throw. He'll air it out deep for Thomas. Oh, he tries to force it in, and it's intercepted. Buda Baker with a pick. And the Cards are going to take over here at their own 22-yard line.
And, Charles, you know, it seems like sometimes when you fall down early, there can be a tendency there to try and get it all back in one fell swoop. And that time, that thinking leads to an interception.
And I believe you brought up a really good point there, Brandon, because you're trying to force plays, right? You're trying to get all back in one shot, just as you mentioned there. And you know you're going to need some big plays to get back into the game. But ultimately, you really can't force what isn't there.
Two minutes to play here in this first half of the NFL playoffs. Coming up at the half, we remind you that we're going to do what we've done all year. We'll get you down to Jonathan Coachman in Orlando. Coach will have the lowdown on what's going on here in this wild card weekend as we begin the road to the upcoming Super Bowl. Now left side, a completion to his tight end. And he'll get this up past the 25 before he's out of bounds. Not a big window to throw. Coverage wasn't too bad there.
Yeah, they had him under wraps pretty well, but somehow able to muscle his way open and catch the ball.
And for the Saints here on third down, an extra defensive back on the field. Now Murray. Going deep for Hopkins. And that's caught inside the 35. Touchdown, Cardinals.
And CD, we have seen some great runs the last few times we've been together, but I think we could at least put this one in our top five. That was a determined gallop there.
Lutz with the extra point, and that makes the score 21 to zip.
The score, Cardinals 21, Saints nothing. Will Lutz.
After the touchdown, Lutz to kick it off. And no return on this one as the fair catch is signaled for and taken.
The Saints take over first and 10 at their own 25-yard line.
The Saints offense on the field ready to get their drive started. And two picks thrown here in this first half alone. We'll see how that affects him.
Can't wait to see where his confidence is, because the great ones, They'll throw four or five picks, and while it'll hurt their team, it won't hurt their confidence. They'll think something was just wrong with the ball or the wind or something was funny. It's never about them. That's how they stay so into the moment and into the game.
Here's a play fake as they set up to throw. He'll find the tight end Sullivan complete. And he's going to be dropped following a pickup of seven past the 30 to the 32.
Let's not quibble about the gain there on second down. That was a positive play because that was a take-what-you-can-get situation. Got out to the tight end. Now it gives them a much better opportunity to convert on third down.
On third and short, they'll try and pick it up through the air. Got a man over the middle, and it's complete. The Saints going to call the first of their timeouts. It's just their first, so they'll have two remaining here before we get to halftime. They'll stick with the passing game as he looks to throw. And for the third time here in this half, it's intercepted. Buda Baker with a pick.
Boy, Charles, that is now three interceptions in three consecutive drives, and you can see he's just got a look of disgust and bad body language, understandably, as he walks off the field.
And I think it comes from the fact that he's not sure what he sees down the field, Brandon. I don't know if he's seeing ghosts. I don't know if he just can't read defenses. I'm not sure what it is, but that's why he's frustrated. And think about the defense right now. Every time they run on the field, they've gone from hoping to intercept the pass to expecting to intercept passes. Their confidence at an all-time high right now.
Give him nine there on the first down completion. Here's second and a yard. Shotgun now for Murray. Flush to his right. Murray, strong running. And he'll get this one down to about the 20-yard line. The Cardinals going to use the first of their timeouts as the clock will stop with 18 seconds to go in the first half. Back-to-back good plays have them on the move on first down. Murray now. Flushed out right. And he'll be out of bounds, taking it just shy of the 10 at the 11 or the 12. He'll get eight on the scramble there. It'll be second and a couple. To throw, it's Murray. It's complete to Hopkins. Touchdown, Cardinals! DeAndre Hopkins in the final seconds of the first half. And the Cards continue to pull the playoff surprise as they lead big here on the road. Lutz good on the extra point. And a rout is on here in this first half.
Saints nothing. Will Lutz set to kick off.
So 6 seconds, all that remains of this first half as the kick is away. And not wanting to risk anything here late in the half, he'll just take a knee and they'll bring the football out to the 25. Getting set for their next drive, the New Orleans offense. And only 6 seconds on the clock, so time likely for just one play. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. So we come upon halftime here in this NFC wild card matchup. As we'll get you over to Orlando, where standing by is Jonathan Coachman. He has our EA Sports halftime report. All right, Coach, thanks very much. Fine work as always as we welcome you back for quarter number three. One of these two teams about to play their final half of the season as we're back at it in this NFC wildcard bout. And he will not bring it out. It's a touchback.
Cut, cut.
They go play action here on first. Rush coming, and he's taken down.
Isaiah Simmons gets him for a loss of 10 yards from his linebacker spot. But when you see a quarterback retreating away from the line of scrimmage toward the other goal line like that, usually doesn't end well.
You're exactly right about that. Normally, if they're moving from side to side, they've got a chance maybe to get back upfield. He was trying to shake defenders and extend the play, but it doesn't work out very well for them at all. You need those extra yards on the other side of the line of scrimmage. Now you're digging a hole for your offense.
16 yards on the play. It's now third down.
They'll drop to throw. Looking left side, he's got it, complete.
And he is going to have a Saints first down as they're able to get the third down conversion.
There's a nice pickup right there, and after watching that play, I'm thinking about all the lost opportunities that they've had so far in this game. But right now, just focus on continuing to move the ball the way they did on the last play.
They'll look to throw here on first down. That is hauled in by Michael Thomas. And he'll go down, but not before getting this inside the 30.
I don't know what they talked about at halftime. Whatever it was, it worked. They look like a different team here in the third quarter.
Yeah, I doubt that there are very many trash cans that got kicked over, that type of a speech. I think what they did was they analyzed what worked in the first half, what didn't, and figured out a better game plan.
And the result here, a pickup of 8, leaves them with 2 to go on second down.
Decided to hand it off that time on the run-pass option.
Appeared to be an easy decision. Just gave it inside. Nice, steady gain.
Second and 2.
Hey, we got a seal. We got a seal. We got a seal. I'm coming. Kill, kill, kill. Kill, kill, kill.
Not a whole lot there. The defense was ready, it looked, for that run-pass option.
You get the sense that next time he has that opportunity, he may keep it himself and get to the perimeter. Probably owes his back a little bit of an apology on that one, huh? Let's go, defense.
They'll run out of the gun with Kamara. And he'll take this one down near the 15. It's the Pro Bowler Chandler Jones who makes the tackle.
Not too many offenses want to turn down long drives, but when you're down what they are, they've got to pay it off with some points.
Now they'll switch it up here and look to throw. And his pass is intercepted for the 4th time today.
Isaiah Simmons picking it off.
He's at the 50, the 30, 10, and they will score. It's a pick 6 for the Cardinals touchdown. This D wanting to put it away before we even get to the 4th quarter, widening that margin a bit further.
And while they won't just empty the bench just yet, if you're a backup, start loosening up. I think you'll get a chance to play before this one is over now with that type of a cushion.
Lutz with the extra point, and that will extend this big lead. So they throw the pick 6. They'll get another shot at it now as this one's in the air.
And it'll come out to the 25 as he will not attempt a return.
The Saints offense on the field, ready to get their drive started. And following the pick 6, and then decent field position in throwing that pick 6, we'll see how they attack this drive.
And I think all you say to your guy is, listen, let's just take care of the football a little bit better. Make some better decisions on this drive, and they'll probably help him a little bit with maybe some really high percentage throws early to let him get settled back
in.
Yeah,
but they told us, they've got confidence. That's not a problem.
Yeah, not a problem at all. They just want to make sure they get things settled down a little bit for their offense and give their defense a little bit of a chance to rest.
And give him 6 yards here as he stopped near the 35 at the 34.
And there's a run to be happy with. Good, solid yardage. He'll take that anytime you hand the ball to a back.
And this defense going to bring out a couple extra DBs here on 3rd and a yard.
Hey, we got a seal. We got a seal. We got a seal. Pick me up.
Firing quickly here, and that's complete. And he's going to have a first down as he's brought down at the 44-yard line. That time the conversion comes courtesy of the RPO.
And know what it did? It moved the sticks. Nice pickup on third down. Even better decision.
A 10th carry for Kamara. And a good pickup there. He gets about six up to midfield.
Frustrating for a defense, energizing for an offense. Finding a way to create that type of yardage in your running game, that'll make the guys carrying the ball very, very happy.
One quarter remains in this NFC wild card matchup. You're watching the NFL on EA Sports. Second down at four. They run it again with Kamara. And he stopped immediately there. No gain on the play that time, and they'll look to convert on what'll be a third and four. Maybe I'm wrong, but it looked like even if he had opted to keep that, I don't think there was going to be much to gain.
Seemed like it was perfectly defense, and know what they say. Those guys on the other side, they get paid too.
Throw left side complete. That's Morgan. And he's out of bounds as he gets this down to the 45.
I like watching the wide receiver screen because it's a real teamwork play. Because guess what? The guy catching the ball, he'll get all the credit. But how about the people up the block in front of him, either fellow receivers or offensive linemen? That makes that play a really nice timing play, and sometimes it can break big.
He'll let this go for the end zone. And this is caught on the sideline. But no, they'll say out of bounds. He caught it, but was not in bounds, incomplete.
We've seen that the deep ball has been a part of their game plan all afternoon, but they've had trouble hooking up on it, unable to successfully find the end zone over the top.
He'll try again with the arm here on second down. He's going to let it go again. And this is incomplete. Oh, he looked like he had a pretty good line on that. Well, that would have been a big play, but he could not pull it in.
And 10 yards to go.
Well, this drive, they're a perfect 2 of 2 on third down conversions, but they need a full 10 yards here. Back to throw again. It's a short one here, complete to the tight end. And he'll get this only to about the 38 as they stop him a few yards shy of the line to gain. They get seven there, but it brings up fourth. Got to try it here. He's back to throw. Looking middle, and that's complete. And they're able to get this one past the 30 to the 25-yard line.
Saints, first down. First and 10 at the 25.
From the gun, it's a run for Kamara. Just a yard on the first down carry, so it's second and 9.
But that call makes sense because they've been throwing it well on this drive, and once again they show passing formation, showing the shotgun. Then they ran out of it. That's a nice play by them defensively, though, to hold it to a short gain.
Second and 9 now. And he's got it. Touchdown, Saints. A great play there. There to make the grab. And the Saints are finally into the end zone here this fourth quarter.
Look, we all know that sometimes we see upsets in the wild card round. But I have to tell you, in this case, I did not see that coming.
I don't think anyone in the stadium saw it coming. You and I were coming in before the game, and there was a couple in front of us talking about travel plans for next weekend. They might want to cancel those.
Yeah, I would say so, because right now it's looking more and more like they're going to be one and done. They're probably
Oh, and now they're going to fake it toward the center of the field, but it's incomplete.
Okay, they went for the fake off of the extra point attempt. It's a long way to go, and they didn't get there. Didn't get it completed successfully. Did someone dare them to do that? Did someone double dog dare him to do that?
I was
going to
ask you, maybe they saw something on film, but do you see something on film when those to try something from the 15 on a PAT? I don't know.
The only thing they needed to see on film there was a snap, a hold, and someone kicking the ball through the post.
Hines opting not to risk it, and this will come out to the 25. Next drive and at the line, the Cardinal offense. They have bucked the trend so far. Sterling performance to this point on the road, no less, in the wild card round. And they look to finish things off here in this fourth quarter. Now the first play of the drive there is incomplete. They're still throwing the football here. Now, obviously, the incompletion stops the clock. That's a bad thing.
Feels to me like they're just keeping them honest on defense, because you know they're going to stack the line of scrimmage to try and stop any type of a running play. Short little passes may work in exchange of running plays. Keep the clock moving, keep them moving.
I guess you're right. If they can get some first downs, just as good as running the football. They do get a couple, but they'll be left staring at a 3rd and 8 coming up.
And it's 3rd down.
Get in the weight room. Hey, Mike 20, Mike 20.
Hey, hold on.
31, check 31. Or 20.
Play action. Now it's Murray. Escaping the pressure right. And it's incomplete. Took a shot, couldn't connect.
They've been trying and trying, but they haven't sacked him yet. He's been able to get away and make plays. Tried to make another one downfield right there, but to no avail. They'll have to keep up the pursuit, though, and not let him get hot.
Fielded just inside the 30. A 40-yard punt, 1 yard on the return, and the Saints will take over with a 1st down and 10. Getting set for their next drive, the New Orleans offense. They are most likely staring at a cold end to their season here in this wild card round. Nothing has gone right so far, and they are, to be frank, in desperation mode now as they begin with a 1st and 10.
13 yards on the play. And the Saints, 1st down.
They'll look to throw now on 1st down. Eluding the pressure right. And he'll just get rid of it. So it's Saints football as we get you reset. So now 2nd and 10 after the incompletion on 1st down. He's going to let it fly. And he drops it incomplete. And their struggles continue here.
This defense was definitely alert to the possibility of the deep ball, and they were more than ready for it.
They've got the lead, 4th quarter. Maybe can expect more passes like that downfield. And this will be incomplete. Boy, can you believe this? That one probably should have been picked too. Instead, it's 4th down.
At this point in the game, they've got to continue to try anything they can. They're still working at it, even though this one feels like a lost cause.
As expected, they're going for it to keep the drive alive. Wide open receiver complete. And he's going to get this all the way down inside the 35.
Well, this game was decided a while ago, and that completion there is going to artificially inflate his passing numbers. So right now, the only one really applauding probably his agent as he thinks about angling for a new contract.
Now a throw here, hauled in. And he's going to get this down near the 20-yard line. On 1st down, he'll drop to throw. Going down the middle, and it's complete. And he is into the end zone. Touchdown, New Orleans. A great effort there. With now 2 fourth-quarter touchdowns. And the Saints get a small measure of revenge as they cut into this fourth-quarter deficit. Now Greg Zuerlein on for the extra point. And he bangs it home. It makes it now 35-13, our score. is the kickoff unit as they run up and send this one away. On the return, it's Nyheim Hines. And he'll be brought down right on the chalk of the 20.
The Cardinals take over first and 10 at their own 20-yard line.
Ready to go with their next drive, and at the line, the Cardinal offense. And a few kneel downs should just about do it. Now, defensively, they do have all three timeouts, but very little reason to use them at this point. And he's going to get 7 out of this before being taken down at the 27.
That's it. That's what you want. Straight ahead, positive gain. Just keep that clock ticking.
A good run, got 7 on first. Here's 2nd and 3. Back to throw it. Murray. Flush to his right. Oh, now it's Stripp. He loses the football. But I think a Cardinal was able to gain possession, yes. So they will hold on to the ball. And I know it's hard to find solace on one side when the season ends, no matter where it ends, but especially in the playoffs, because there's all that build up to the moment. But I would imagine the post-game locker room speech, it'll have a pretty positive spin.
It should. They've made a heck of a run to get.